this video, I'll show you the best methods for Digimon Story Time Stranger to get you more FPS, improve performance, and fix FPS drops. In the first method, you will set permanent high priority, click on Windows, now search for regedit, then click on the corresponding option, under this field, paste the address that I will leave in the description below, now press enter, right click on image file execution options, then click on new and key, name this key as Digimon Storytime Stranger.exe and press enter, now right click on it, then click on new and key, name it as birth options and press enter, now right click on it and click on new and deword 32-bit value, name it as CPU priority class and press enter, now right click on it and then click on modify, inside of its data type 3 and click on OK. In the second method, you will disable full screen optimizations, open Digimon Storytime Stranger, press Windows and D to minimize it, right click on the taskbar and click on Task Manager, now select Details, then search for Digimon, now right click on Digimon Storytime Stranger.exe and click on Open File Location, right click on Digimon Storytime Stranger.exe, click on Properties, then select Compatibility, check Disable Full Screen Optimizations, and then click on Apply and OK. In the third method, you will set the High Performance Power Plant, search for Power CFG.cpl, click on the corresponding option, and then select the High Performance Power Plant. In the fourth method, you will optimize the NVIDIA graphics settings, right click on the desktop, click on Show More Options, and NVIDIA Control Panel, click on Manage 3D Settings, look for Low Latency Mode, and set it to Ultra, look for Power Management Mode, and set it to Prefer Maximum Performance, and then click on Apply in the lower right corner. In the fifth method, you will set the most optimized graphic settings, open the game, click on Options and Graphic Settings, Display Mode, select Borderless, Frame Rate, select the highest possible value, VSync, select Off, FXAA, select On, MSAA, select 0x, TAA, select On, Depth of Field, select On, Bloom, select Off, Volumetric Fog, select On, Screen Space Reflection, select On, Ambient Occlusion, select On, Texture Quality, select High, Texture Filtering, select Anisotropic 16x, and Character Density, select Low. So this is the performance result. And that was the video. Let me know in the comment section below if this video was helpful to you. If you want to boost and optimize performance in other games, you can subscribe to this channel and then always learn new methods when I upload new videos. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.